Dear student, due to coronavirus, school started online classes for your study. So you can subscribe Golden Flower Palia YouTube channel, like and press the bell icon.
Hello students, today we are going to discuss about next to the electric flux and area vector that we had a discussion in the last video lecture. And today we will discuss about the Gauss theorem and its derivation. Here I have written Gauss theorem. It states that electric flux emanating through a closed surface is 1 upon epsilon naught times the charge enclosed by the surface. Okay, so this is the Gauss theorem. Electric flux, we had a discussion. What is electric flux? You must have to watch the last video also to understand what is electric flux, and there I have told you it is the electric field lines passing through a surface. Okay, so when this surface is kept normal to that one, and I have given the expression for that also. To understand rest of the part of the Gauss theorem, you must have an idea about the electric flux. You must be knowing that how the electric flux is passing through the surface, when it is to be taken as positive, when it is taken to be negative. So you must have an idea about electric flux and as well as the area vector. Okay, so here I am going to state about the Gauss theorem today, and we will solve the derivation of the Gauss theorem also. So what is that Gauss theorem? Gauss theorem, I told you, it is stating that electric flux emanating through a closed surface is 1 upon epsilon naught times the charge enclosed by the surface. The first thing you have to know that any surface will emanate the electric flux, will give the electric flux, will give out the electric flux only when it has charge enclosed in it. Okay, until it is having a charge, until it is not having a charge, it is not going to be produce electric flux. Okay, electric flux will not come out from the surface until it is having a charge in it. Okay, like the same way we will take the for the different cases. Okay, we will discuss about the different cases of the enclosed surface here. So first you have to understand that what is the Gauss theorem all about. It is telling that if a charge is kept in a closed surface, like a room in which you are living, there it is a charge kept, how much flux will come out that room? Okay, it depends upon the charge enclosed by that room. Is that clear? So how much he told, what is the electric flux is coming out from a closed surface, that must be 1 upon epsilon naught times. What is the epsilon naught? Epsilon naught is the permittivity of free space. That's value was 8.85 into 10 to the power minus 12. Okay, so here what he has told, he told that very simple phenomena he has given, that flux will come out, that is 1 upon epsilon naught times the charge enclosed by the surface. So charge enclosed by the surface, that is Q by epsilon naught. So more correctly, if we write this formula, then we can write it as phi E and integration of E dot ds. This is the way to write the electric flux. Okay, to show the electric flux by the mathematical expression, and it is equal to Q by epsilon naught. Okay, if a surface is enclosing 2q charge, so then it will be 2q upon epsilon naught. 3q charge, 3q upon epsilon naught. Okay, is it clear to everybody? So this is the Gauss theorem. It is stating about that the flux will come out from a closed surface depends upon the charge enclosed by the surface. Okay, so this is the concept of Gauss theorem. Okay, so Gauss theorem, it was for the symmetrical figure, like we have studied Coulomb's law, and then we drive in the formula for electric field, for electric dipole, for dipoles, different cases we have driven that formula, and electric field for a point charge, and it was quite complicated. Okay, it was quite complicated because the formula that was given by Coulomb, it was 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 upon r square. Okay, quite complicated formula it was, but this formula is quite simple. It is q upon epsilon naught, just okay, q upon epsilon naught, and using this formula we can calculate electric field due to the different cases, due to the different kind of objects. Is that clear? So this is the Gauss theorem all about. So Gauss theorem's statement you have to learn because it is very important chapter and very important topic. It is always they ask in the board examination, state the Gauss theorem and prove it. And any one of the application of the Gauss theorem is given along with the statement of Gauss theorem. Okay, so it is very important. It's going to be very important for the session. And here we are going to discuss how to derive the Gauss theorem. Okay, how Gauss has driven this formula using the Coulomb force, using the Coulombian law that we have studied in the first chapter. Okay, so I'm going to give you proof about the Gauss theorem. So suppose we are having a spherical surface and it is a charge given plus q, this spherical surface. Okay, plus q charge is given to it at its center. A charge is kept at its center. Now, to find out the electric flux passing through this closed surface, I've told you when we were having the discussion about area vector, and I told you when we are having the plane surface, then it is easy to find out the area. Okay, to find out the electric flux coming out from that surface. If we are having the different kind of area, a different kind of surface, like we are having a spherical surface, we are having a cone surface, then how to find out? Then we just need to make the part of that figure, make a part of that 3D body. Okay, so I'm here going to be make this 3D body into different parts, infinite number of parts. I'm going to divide it. Okay, suppose I've taken a small area element over its surface. Here I've taken a small surface area over this spherical body. Okay, it's a sphere, hollow sphere. I've given a charge q at the center of this sphere. Okay, so at the center of the sphere there is a charge q kept, and the radius of this sphere, it is r, let it is be r, and a small area element we have considered here because we have divided this spherical body into infinite number of parts. This area is being divided into different number of parts, infinite number of parts, and a small part, it is called ds or da. Okay, whatever you can write it as, ds. Okay, so ds is the area vector and it is always perpendicular to the surface, that I have told you. And the area vector, what is the area vector? Area vector is actually the normal drawn to the surface. Okay, whatever the area of the surface we are questioning about, we have to draw the normal on that surface, and that normal drawn, it is called area vector. So here it is the area vector. So ds vector is the area vector of this small area, ds area. Ds area is an infinitesimally small area. Okay, we have divided this curved surface area into infinite number of parts. Okay, so one part is having area ds and its area vector is ds vector. Okay, what we have studied about electric field lines, for the charge, positive charge, they are starting from the charge and goes to infinity, they end at infinity, they terminate at infinity. And for the negative charge, they start from infinity and end and terminate at minus q. That we have studied in electric field lines. So here charge plus q is kept at the center of this surface, and for this charge q, how much electric field will produce and what will be the direction of that electric field? That will be also away, okay, perpendicularly out from the surface. So here I'm going to make the sign for electric field. This is the electric field vector, E vector, that is also starting from plus Q and going to the infinite distance, infinity. It is going to be terminate over there. So when it passes from a spherical surface, it always perpendicular to the surface, and we had a discussion about that also. If it is having the different component other than the perpendicular, it must have a horizontal and a vertical component, and in the horizontal we had a discussion about equipotential surface like that. Okay, so now we have electric field moving away from the surface area. It is in the direction of ds vector. So how much electric flux is going to be pass out from this small area element? We call it area element. Okay, how much flux is going to be pass out, because it is very small area, so very small flux is going to be pass out from there. So very small, infinitesimally small electric flux is shown by the d phi e, okay, to e dot ds vector. Okay, e dot ds vector, because it is infinitesimally small, so a very small flux will come out from it, very less amount of flux will come out from this. Infinitesimally small flux is shown by d phi e, and it is shown by the expression E dot ds. Okay, electric field and ds. So what is the angle between two of them, E vector and ds vector? There it is zero angle, because both are in the same direction, both are perpendicular to the surface of this closed sphere. So what is d phi e here? D phi is equal to E ds cos zero. So we can write it as d phi e is equal to e ds. Okay, so for finding the flux from whole of this sphere, how much flux is coming out from whole sphere, for that we have to integrate this equation, because integration is going to be expand this mathematical expression. So expansion is done by the integration, and reduction is done by the differentiation. So here I'm going to expand this expression. If it is true for this small area, it will be true for the large area also. So for finding the large area, for finding the flux for this whole sphere, we are going to integrate this equation. So on integrating this equation, we get phi e in place of d phi e, because after integrating d is going to be removed. D phi e's integration is phi e, and here it is integration, closed integration we are going to use for this, because this is a closed surface area, that is called e ds. Okay, so d phi e, it is equal to e, and area, closed surface area of ds. So here we have taken r is the radius of this sphere. After integrating this small area, we'll get the area of this sphere. So what is the area of the sphere? That is 4 pi r square. So we can write here 4 pi r square phi e is equal to, okay, so this what is the electric field at this point? If we consider this point is p, okay, and it is distance, r distance apart from charge q from the center of this sphere O. So OP distance, it is equal to r. So what was the expression for the electric field due to a point charge? We have studied electric field due to a point charge is E equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. So this we have studied in the last videos in electric field due to the point charge. So using this expression in this equation, equation number 1, I'm writing here. So remove it. So what will be the electric flux? Phi e will be equal to, from equation 1, this will be equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square, and that is 4 pi r square. Okay, so whatever can be cancelled, you cancel it. What will be left behind? R square, R square, 4 pi, 4 pi, q by epsilon naught. It's quite simple derivation it is. Easily we can calculate how much flux is going to be come out from the closed surface. Okay, so this was the proof of Gauss theorem. It can be done for the irregular figure also. It was the regular, it was the symmetrical figure I have taken because it is quite simple. It is quite simple to solve it. Okay, so this was all the Gauss theorem about. Okay, what happens if we are going to keep a dipole inside a closed surface? How much flux will come out from a closed surface? Okay, so how much flux is coming out from a closed surface? This is, suppose this is a closed surface and we have kept a dipole. Okay, this is a question. How much flux will come out from this closed surface? So how much charge on the dipole it is? We have to just see that what is the charge inside the closed surface kept. So inside the closed surface, how much charge, how much amount of charge is kept? That is plus q minus q, that is zero. So how much flux is going to be come out from this closed surface? That flux, it will be equal to zero. Okay, why it is zero? Because due to dipole, the total charge inside a closed surface, that is zero, because dipole is an arrangement having equal and opposite charges separated by a small distance apart from each other. Okay, so this is the question. Many more questions are based on the Gauss theorem. You can solve it. Okay, solve number of numerical related to the Gauss theorem. Okay, we will meet in the next video lecture with the application of Gauss theorem. Okay.
Do self-study at home and stay home, save lives.